I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 65.1. Questioner, could you first please give us an indication of the instrument's condition and the level of vital and physical energies? Answer, I am Ra. This instrument's vital energies are as previously stated. The physical energies are greatly distorted towards weakness at this space-time due to the distortion complexes symptomatic of that which you call the arthritic condition. The level of psychic attack is constant but is being dealt with by this instrument in such a way as to eliminate serious difficulties due to its fidelity and that of the support group. Question 65.2. Questioner, I may be recovering a little ground already covered today, but I am trying to get a more clear picture of some things that I don't understand and possibly develop a plan of my own for activity in the future. I have the impression that in the near future the seeking will increase by many who now are incarnate in the physical on this planet. Their seeking will increase because they will become more aware of the creation as it is and as it is opposed, I might say, to the creation of man. Their orientation and their thinking will be, by catalyst of a unique nature, reoriented to thinking of more basic concepts, shall I say. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. The generalities of expression can never be completely correct. However, we may note that when faced with a hole in the curtain, an entity's eyes may well peer for the first time through the window beyond. This tendency is probable given the possibility-probability vortices active within your space-time and time-space continue at this nexus. Question 65.3. Questioner, I have assumed that the reason that so many wanderers and those harvested third-density entities who have been transferred here find it a privilege and an exceptionally beneficial time to be incarnate upon this planet is that the effect that I just spoke of gives them the opportunity to be more fully of service because of the increased seeking. Is this, in general, correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is the intention which wanderers had prior to incarnation. There are many wanderers whose dysfunction with regard to the planetary ways of your peoples have caused, to some extent, a condition of being caught up in a configuration of mind complex activity which, to the corresponding extent, may prohibit the intended service. Question 65.4. Questioner, I noticed that you are speaking more slowly than usual. Is there a reason for this? Answer, I am Ra. This instrument is somewhat weakened although strong in vital energy and well able to function at this time is somewhat more fragile than the usual condition we find. We may note a continuing bearing of the physical distortion called pain which is a weakening effect upon physical energy. In order to use the considerable store of available energy without harming the instrument we are attempting to channel even more narrow band than is our wont. Question 65.5. Questioner. Have I properly analyzed the condition that creates the possibility of greater service as follows? Seniority by vibration of incarnation has greatly polarized those upon the surface of the planet now, and the influx of wanderers has greatly increased the mental configuration toward things of a more spiritual nature. This would be, I assume, one of the factors creating a better atmosphere for service. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 65.6. Questioner, would the coming changes as we progress into fourth density such as changes in the physical third density planet due to the heating effect and changes such as the ability of people to perform what we term paranormal activities act as catalyst to create a greater seeking? Answer, I am Ra. This is partially correct. The paranormal events occurring are not designed to increase seeking but are manifestations of those whose vibratory configuration enables these entities to contact the gateway to intelligent infinity. These entities capable of paranormal service may determine to be of such service on a conscious level. This, however, is a function of the entity and its free will and not the paranormal ability. The correct portion of your statements is the greater opportunity for service due to the many changes which will offer many challenges, difficulties, and seeming distresses within your illusion to many who then will seek to understand, if we may use this misnomer, the reason for the malfunctioning of the physical rhythms of their planet. Moreover, there exists probability-possibility vortices which spiral towards your bellicose actions. Many of these vortices are not of the nuclear war but of the less annihilatory but more lengthy so-called conventional war. This situation, if formed in your illusion, would offer many opportunities for seeking and for service. Question 65.7. Questioner, how would conventional warfare offer the opportunities for seeking and service? Answer, I am Ra. The possibility probabilities exist for situations in which great portions of your continent and the globe in general might be involved in the type of warfare which you might liken to guerrilla warfare. The ideal of freedom from the so-called invading force of either the controlled fascism or the equally controlled social common ownership of all things would stimulate great quantities of contemplation upon the great polarization implicit in the contrast between freedom and control. In this scenario which is being considered at this time-space nexus, the idea of obliterating valuable sites and personnel would not be considered a useful one. Other weapons will be used which do not destroy as your nuclear arms would. In this ongoing struggle, the light of freedom would burn within the mind, body, spirit complexes capable of such polarization. Lacking the opportunity for overt expression of the love of freedom, the seeking for inner knowledge would take root aided by those of the brothers and sisters of sorrow which remember their calling upon this sphere. Question 65.8. Questioner, are you saying then that this possible condition of war would be much more greatly spread across the surface of the globe than anything we have experienced in the past and therefore touch a larger percentage of the population in this form of catalyst? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. There are those now experimenting with one of the major weapons of this scenario, that is the so-called psychotronic group of devices which are being experimentally used to cause such alterations in wind and weather as will result in eventual famine. If this program is not counted and proves experimentally satisfactory, the methods in this scenario would be made public. There would then be what those whom you call Russians hope to be a bloodless invasion of their personnel in this and every land deemed valuable. However, the peoples of your culture have little propensity for bloodless surrender. Question 65.9. Questioner, we would seem to have dual catalysts operating, and the question is which one is going to act first? The prophecies, I will call them, made by Edgar Cayce indicated many earth changes and I am wondering about the mechanics describing the future. Ra, it has been stated, is not a part of time and yet we concern ourselves with possibility-probability vortices. It is very difficult for me to understand how the mechanism of prophecy operates. What is the value of such a prophecy such as Cayce made with respect to earth changes and all of these scenarios? Answer, I am Ra. Consider the shopper entering the store to purchase food with which to furnish the table for the time period you call a week. Some stores have some items, others a variant set of offerings. We speak of these possibility-probability vortices when asked with the understanding that such are as a can, jar, or portion of goods in your store. It is unknown to us as we scan your time-space whether your peoples will shop hither or yon. We can only name some of the items available for the choosing. The, shall we say, record which the one you call Edgar read from is useful in that same manner. There is less knowledge in this material of other possibility-probability vortices and more attention paid to the strongest vortex. We see the same vortex but also see many others. Edgar's material could be likened unto 100 boxes of your cold cereal, another vortex likened unto 3, or 6, or 50 of another product which is eaten by your peoples for breakfast. That you will breakfast is close to certain. The menu is your own choosing. The value of prophecy must be realized to be only that of expressing possibilities. Moreover, it must be, in our humble opinion, carefully taken into consideration that any time-space viewing, whether by one of your time-space or by one such as we who view the time-space from a dimension, shall we say, exterior to it will have a quite difficult time expressing time measurement values. Thus prophecy given in specific terms is more interesting for the content or type of possibility predicted than for the space-time nexus of its supposed occurrence. Question 65.10. Questioner, so we have the distinct possibility of two different types of catalyst creating an atmosphere of seeking that is greater than that which we experience at present. There will be much confusion, especially in the scenario of Earth changes, simply because there have been many predictions of these changes by many groups giving many and sundry reasons for the changes. Can you comment on the effectiveness of this type of catalyst and the rather wide pre-knowledge of the coming changes, but also the wide variation in explanation for these changes? Answer: I am Ra. Given the amount of strength of the possibility-probability vortex which posits the expression by the planet itself of the difficult bithing of the planetary self into fourth density, it would be greatly surprising were not many which have some access to space-time able to perceive this vortex. The amount of this cold cereal in the grocery, to use our previous analogy, is disproportionately large. Each which prophesies does so from an unique level, position, or vibratory configuration. Thus biases and distortions will accompany much prophecy. Question 65.11. Questioner: this entire scenario for the next 20 years seems to be aimed at producing an increase in seeking and an increase in the awareness of the natural creation, but also a terrific amount of confusion. Was it the pre-incarnative objective of many of the wanderers to attempt to reduce this confusion? Answer: I am Ra. It was the aim of wanderers to serve the entities of this planet in whatever way was requested, and it was also the aim of wanderers that their vibratory patterns might lighten the planetary vibration as a whole, thus ameliorating the effects of planetary disharmony and palliating any results of this disharmony. Specific intentions such as aiding in a situation not yet manifest are not the aim of wanderers. Light and love go where they are sought and needed, and their direction is not planned aforetimes.